Stretch your hands towards Prophet Junior tonight, please. And say, use him, Lord.
Use him, Lord.
Say, use him, Lord.
Use him, Lord.
Say, use him, Lord.
Use him, Lord.
Come on, give the Lord a good clap of hands. Lord, bless you.
Praise him. Put your hands together for Jesus tonight. Somebody call him by his name. Lift your hands and glorify. Lift your hands and glorify. Begin to thank you for what you have done tonight in your life, what he's about to do. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. We praise you. We praise you. We name. We magnify your name. Begin to invite the power of the Holy Ghost, the right hand of God. His power and the Bible says that Jesus Christ is seated at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for us. For the Bible said he has given him a name and is far above every other name, and at the name of Jesus Christ, things in heaven shall power. Things on the earth shall power. Things under the earth shall power. Oh, we worship you tonight. We praise you, 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 we praise you. Oh, la 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 la. Open your mind, get ready to receive. Get ready to receive from Jesus. Get ready to receive from the Holy Ghost. Get ready to experience His power. Walk in your life to break the yoke, to break the chains, to break the fetters, to destroy the works of darkness, to mend stony hearts. Jesus Christ is the anointing of the anointing one.
It is the anointing that shall break every yoke.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Glory,
Lord. Glory to Jesus. Spirit of God. Lift your hands in the heavens tonight. The Bible said we look unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. The Bible said the way he is holy. He meant so much. When we lift our hands, it represents that he is here. And the way he is holy. He is present. Amen, somebody. The Bible said in the presence of the Lord there is fullness of joy, and in his right hand there are pleasures forevermore. David said, if I go to the heavens, he is there. If I'm on the earth, he is there. If I'm under the earth, he is there. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Spirit of God. Lamb of God, Lamb of God, Lamb of God. And these are holy hands. We are lifting up holy hands. Lift your hands to the Lord tonight. For our God is here, and where he is holy.
Oh,
But in spite of our ungodly works, His love is greater than our sins.
Hallelujah.
The Bible said when we are not faithful, He is still faithful. And it is because of His love we are healed, we are saved, and we are delivered. Because of His love, we are able to be born again. The Bible said, for God so loved the world, that He sent His only begotten Son. And whosoever shall believe on Him should not perish, but shall have everlasting life. The Bible said that God sent not the Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. to them that will believe on the Son of God, the grace of God. It is that love for humanity. The Bible said that we did not deserve the love of God. The Bible said that we were enemies of God, aliens of God, wicked before God, unjust before God, unrighteous before God. The Bible said that we served Satan before Jesus came. Because we were all born in sin and shaped in iniquity.
Hallelujah.
And even though He was the one that created us, our image looked nothing like Him. When men fall, when Adam failed, our birthright was sold out, and our image was no longer after the Heavenly Father, but was after Satan, and wickedness flowed out of the hearts of men.
Hallelujah.
But when Jesus came, the love of God was manifested and shared to the Holy Ghost. When Jesus went on that cross with great suffering and great pain and great agony, when upon His body He took all our sicknesses, our disease, our grief, our pain, our hurt, our suffering. When He carried that cross in our place, when He was wounded in our place, bruised in our place, chastised in our place, died in our place, that was the love of God manifested. Even though we did not deserve it, He still loved us. Amen, somebody. And that is grace. Amen. That is grace. Amen, somebody. And if we think that we are righteous before God, we better think again. Our righteousness comes through our faith in the love of God. And the love of God is Jesus. Then somebody say, God's love towards man is the Son of God. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. He came to seek and to save that which was lost. Sometimes we are baptized and God begins to work and change our lives and our heart begins to insist, that heart of pride, amen, that once belonged to Satan, amen, somebody, amen, try to sneak back in and try to tell you, you are righteous, you are only made righteous by your faith in the power of His blood.
Amen.
When God look at us, He doesn't look at us as persons or individuals to look for our righteousness. He looks at us through the blood of Jesus Christ. To the blood of Jesus Christ that had redeemed us. We in ourselves cannot stand before the presence of God. Amen, somebody. But through the blood of Jesus, we are able to enter. The Bible says we have boldness. Somebody said boldness. Through the blood of Jesus, we have access. Somebody said access. Into the throne of grace. Into where? The throne of grace. Where all that seems to be impossible is made possible. Turn to somebody and say, I do not know. Look at them. It might be a stranger, a neighbor, someone you don't know. Turn to them and say, I do not know what is your problem or what you are believing for. Or what seems to be impossible with you tonight is possible with God. For all things are made possible to them that will believe. Through His blood you have boldness. You have access to enter into His throne of grace with all things. Somebody said all things are possible. Give Him praise tonight. As we sit and quickly go into communion tonight.
Jesus.
Believe that all things will be possible for you tonight. God will move for you. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
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 Amen. You are turning your Bibles to the first book of Corinthians, verses 23. The apostle Paul said, he that worketh miracles and signs and wonders amongst us. He said, he did not do it by the works of the law, but by the hearing of faith, the faith of the Son of God. We are justified by that faith. We are changed by that faith. It is not our strength that changes us, but our faith in his strength. Amen, somebody. If you have this a desire to change, to be transformed, your mind, your heart, your lifestyle, and you have been trying on your own, amen, somebody. Many people go to church and still trying on their own. Amen, somebody. Because the only part of the Bible that they understand is the law. Amen, somebody. Don't get me wrong. Amen, somebody. Jesus did not condemn the law. Amen, somebody. Amen, somebody. To the law, we know that we are sinners. If you have ever lied in your life, you are a liar. If you have ever looked at a man or a woman and lust after her, Jesus said, you have already committed the act in your heart. Amen. You are an adulterer, a fornicator. Amen, somebody.
Amen,
amen, somebody.
Amen.
If you have ever stolen something, picked up something that doesn't belong to you, no matter how small it is, you are a thief.
Amen.
In the eyes of God. You have already broken two of God's commandments.
Amen,
amen, somebody.
Amen.
But the fulfillment of the law, the word fulfillment, it was not complete. If I must finish fulfilling something, it means I didn't finish what I started.
Amen.
So he started something with Moses and he sent Jesus to finish it.
Amen.
So we cannot deny the law.
Amen,
amen, somebody.
Amen.
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 Amen, somebody.
Amen.
But the fulfillment of the law is the love of God.
Amen.
Are you understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
The fulfillment of the law is the love of God.
Amen,
amen, somebody.
Amen.
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 Because we as men cannot keep the law. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Are you listening to me tonight?
Amen.
Don't matter how much you try in yourself, you are weak because of the flesh. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
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 But the love of God came and said, listen to me. I will cause you to be born again. Not of the will of men, not of the flesh, but of my spirit and of my word. I will give unto you my spirit because of my love. I will forgive all of your sins. I will break the power of sin over your life. I will take away your sicknesses. I will take away your diseases. I will take away your infirmity. I will take away the guilt of sin over your consciences, over your lives. I will make you anew. Amen, somebody. The law brings judgment, but the love of God brings mercy. Amen, somebody. And you understand what I'm saying tonight? The Bible said that the law of God is divine, but man could not have lived by it alone. Amen, somebody. They have no strength on their own. So whatever you are trying in yourself, you cannot live it in yourself.
Amen.
The apostle said, I now live by my faith in the Son of God.
Amen.
He said, the life which I now live, I live by the faith of the Son of God. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Jesus Christ now lives through us. And if he lives through us, then sin will die in us. It will no longer reign in us. He said in our weaknesses, his strength is made perfected. What you cannot do to change yourself, seek after God and He will change you.
Amen.
Seek after Jesus and He will change you. Amen, somebody.
Amen,
amen, somebody.
Amen.
In the book of Mark, it said, "A wicked and a perverse generation seeking after a sign. They seek after signs and wonders." But Jesus said, "The sign I will give unto you is the sign of Jonas the prophet. And that sign is repentance." When we begin to repent, when we begin to turn to Jesus. Amen, somebody. That is salvation. And where there is salvation, there will be limitless miracles and signs and wonders. We look for the sign first, for the sign that God wants to see is the turning of our hearts towards Him. When our heart is turned towards Him, there's nothing that He will not do for you. You see, Jonah was sent to warn them of the wrath of God and to repent. Amen, somebody. And that's a sign. Amen, somebody. That sign is repentance. I'm not talking about a one day repentance. I'm talking about a life of repentance. Some people say, well, you can only repent once. Amen, somebody. I tell you, the closer you get to God is the more you see your flaws in your life. Some people are blinded by their flaws and they can't see it. It is too big for them to see anything else. Blinded by ego, blinded by pride. If something is so big that you cannot, amen, somebody. Amen. Like these walls that you cannot see outside. Because these walls, amen, are so big and you cannot see through them. So are the sins in our lives. Sometimes shows our pride, our haughtiness, our anger. Amen, somebody. So are our sins. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Are you listening to me?
Amen.
Are you listening to me?
Amen.
I told you to go and read 2 Peter and said, "He that lacketh these things are what? Are blind and cannot see afar off." Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Put your hands together for the Lord tonight. But the Lord is that Spirit, and then the Spirit of God is. Give us liberty. And the Bible said, by that very same Spirit, we are what? We are changed. We are changed by the Spirit of God. From glory, into His glorious presence. Amen.
Amen,
amen, somebody.
Amen.
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 So we got to thank Him for His love, for His grace, for His mercy, for what He has done for us on the cross.
Amen.
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 From verses 20, He said, "For I have received the Lord, that which also I deliver unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which He was betrayed, took bread. And when He had given thanks, He broke it and said, 'Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me.' And after the same manner also, He took the cup, and when He had supped, saying, 'This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do He as often as He drink it in remembrance of me.' For as often as He eat this bread and drink this cup, He do show the Lord's death until He come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup." Remember when I said we live a life of repentance? Every time we get a little closer to God, every area in our life where that light is not, it has not shined upon. As we get closer to Him, that light begins to shine there. And we begin to see ourselves more and more. I told you on Wednesday that the closer, amen, amen, the closer you get to God is the further away you realize that you are.
Amen.
Amen, someone. A person that thinks that they are walking very closely with God lacks knowledge and wisdom and understanding. The Bible said the very angels in heaven cannot fathom him, cannot know him.
Amen.
Every day they are around the throne of God crying, holy, holy, as God reveals something new unto them. Are you understanding what I'm saying?
Amen.
But what God reveals unto us is what he wants us to know.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Whatever God has revealed unto you is what he wants you to know.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
So the closer you get to God is the more God shows you, listen to me, look how far you are from me. Even though you've been running the race so long, look how far, look at your life, look at your heart, look at where you have to improve, look at where you have to change.
Amen. Amen.
It's
Amen.
The more humble you get.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
People who have true knowledge and wisdom will gain humility. People that have false knowledge and false wisdom become proud and boastful of what they have. What you have is only what God has allowed you to see and to gain. You understand what I'm saying? Whatever you have, whatever you have experienced with God is what he has allowed you to experience and to gain. That's why he said, "Father, resist the proud, and I give grace to the humble." I told you again to read 2 Peter chapter 1. He said, "Grace be and peace be multiplied to you." Amen, somebody. Those who are gaining the knowledge of the Son of God. Amen.
Amen.
The Apostle Paul cried that I might know him. Who is him? And I might know Jesus. And who he really is. Yet he wrote so much for us. And yet he still prayed that he might know him.
Amen.
Most of the books of the New Testament are written by him.
Amen.
Yet still he was still praying that I might know who Jesus really is. And the power of his resurrection. And the fellowship of his suffering. So the scripture said, whatever we know is what God has allowed us to know. Don't let any man think that he know it. Anything or all things. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
I said, amen.
Amen.
So he said, if a man do what? Examine himself. If we would judge ourselves, people, amen, wouldn't find time to judge us our own. Amen, somebody. Because every day we are examining ourselves.
Amen.
We are able to see where we are going wrong before others can point it out.
Amen.
Because we are beholding ourselves in the mirror and represent the Word of God. We can see ourselves through the Word of God.
Amen.
To God's standard for man. And by the Spirit of God we are able to be changed. And that's how that life stays in us, that power stays in us, that anointing stays in us. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
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 She has to get up for the Lord. He said what? Let him remember what? Examine himself and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. But listen, he said, but he that eat it and drink it unworthily, eat it and drink it, damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. This is not just a ceremony of the church. This is not just a ritual of the church. When we take this for granted, we are mocking his works on the cross. We are, our foundation of grace is built on the works of the Son of God. Amen.
Amen.
Some people that grew up in church and they are accustomed taking communion without understanding the dangers that they are in. The word of God is spirit and is life. Amen. And God doesn't want us to take what He has done for us for granted.
Amen.
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 So he said, "But he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body." Not understanding what he has done for us, not truly receiving him as Lord and Savior. And he said, "For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep." For if we would take that time, he said, and judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are what? Chasing of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. And the Bible said, he said, despise not the chastisement of the Lord. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
You understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
So when God allows things to happen to us, we will check ourselves, check our life, check our standing. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Check our lifestyle, our home, see where we are going wrong. When the Bible says to judge yourself, it doesn't mean to condemn yourself, but it means to examine yourself, that you might be able to repent. That you might be able to change that way of thinking, change that lifestyle by the help of Almighty God. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
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 Let the ushers bring the communion tonight as a blessing tonight. I want to pray with everyone to be one at the song of my voice.